Blackstone presents Problem Solver, Maximizing Your Strengths to Make Better Decisions by Cheryl Strauss Einhorn. This book is read by Caroline Shaffer. All charts, diagrams, and photographs that appear in the print edition of this book can be found in the bonus PDF file that accompanies your audiobook CD or download. Disclaimer: names of people and their organizations have been changed to protect their privacy. Have you ever sold anything door-to-door? As I was wrapping up the first draft of this book, my 19-year-old son, Mitchell, was doing just that, selling educational textbooks here in the United States, but far from home in a rural, low-income community where he felt very much an outsider. One morning, he approached a house with an empty driveway and rang the bell. There was no answer. Later that afternoon, he dropped by the same house, now with three cars in the driveway. He rang the bell again. Still, no answer. Dogged in his pursuit of business, when he finished for the evening about 9 p.m., he swung by the house one more time. There were nine cars in front. This time, when he rang the bell, a man in his 50s answered and asked, "What can I do for you?" My son looked down the driveway at the nine cars and looked back at this tired-looking man. There was one thing he really didn't need: a car. But how do you break the ice to talk about something that perhaps this man, or his family, did need? Gesturing at the vehicles in the driveway, my son answered, "I'm here to sell you a car." The man was stunned, only for a brief beat, before they shared a hearty laugh. My son had collected information not from a book or a set of data per se, but valuable information directly from the world he saw in front of him. And he used it to introduce himself not from who he was, but rather from what he'd noticed. This book is dedicated to my son and to everyone who wants to approach decisions in a way that better connects them with others and the world around them. A new type of thinking is essential if mankind is to survive and move toward higher levels. Albert Einstein. The following chart, which you will meet again in Chapter 8, is a snapshot synopsis of the different ways in which people tend to approach problem solving. All of us approach problem solving with a set of skills and a set of habits and biases. In my work on decision making, I've identified five different decision making archetypes. This book is intended to help you identify your archetype, your problem solver profile, so that you can make big decisions better and work more effectively with the other decision makers in your life. Begin Cheetah Sheet 1. Cheetah Sheet 1. Problem Solver Profiles. This chart provides you with a synopsis of the different ways that people tend to approach problem solving. Refer to this chart to better understand your own approach or to consider the decision-making approaches of others. Cheetah Sheet 6, PSP Strengths and Blind Spots, will expand on these PSP characteristics. Archetype: Adventurer. Strengths: Confidence. Speed: Efficiency. Blind Spots: Optimism Bias, Planning Bias, Confirmation Bias, Closeness Communication Bias. Archetype: Detective. Strengths: Committed to Facts. Rational, Realistic. Blind Spots: Confirmation Bias, Planning Fallacy, Projection Bias, Frame Blindness. Archetype: Listener. Strengths: Trusting, Relational, Supportive. Blind Spots: Authority Bias, Liking Bias, Narrative Bias, Social Proof Bias. Archetype: Thinker. Strengths: thoroughness, thoughtfulness, caution. Blind spots: loss aversion, relativity bias, authority bias, frame blindness. Archetype: visionary. Strengths: imaginative, innovative, individualistic. Blind spots: optimism bias, saliency bias, scarcity bias, planning fallacy. End of Cheetah Sheet 1. Introduction: The Data of Living. Learning without thought is labor lost. Confucius. When we think about the future, we hope for many of the same things: good health for ourselves and our families, a secure income, a basic sense of safety and control over our lives. In these uncertain times, even such simple desires can seem out of reach because the future feels so unpredictable. But the future has always been unpredictable, unruly, and beyond our knowledge. Still, there are skills and tools that we can all use to plan for our future that are practical, actionable, and available to everyone. These skills bake our values and desires into our plans so that we can better work toward our particular vision of the future. Like all skills, these planning and decision-making tools require both an investment of time and a willingness to try new ways of thinking. But isn't that investment worth it? Ironically, decision-making is generally not even seen as a skill that we might want to develop, especially when we consider the universality of its application. All of us make decisions every day, large and small. Who we are is a series of choices, and our decisions are the data of living. Rarely, though, do we take the time to examine our decisions or even look inward to consider the psychology of our decision-making. How do we, personally, identify and understand our decision-making approach and its implications? Although there are some decision-making tools available, including my books about personal and professional problem-solving, Problem Solved and Investing in Financial Research, the existing tools and strategies don't guide us to learn about ourselves. Instead,
we hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.